Vintage Rally, 1999. It's a platform.
Morris Cowley, or half a Morris Cowley. It's the one that's in the process of restoration. It hasn't still got a registration number on it, and it hasn't still got a body on it. But that is a sharp edge radiator. It's an unusual radiator on that one. An early type car. 1929, fabric bodied Morris Minor, 847cc. It was registered in July 1929 in Middlesex in the name of John Clarks. And the miner, G. Midget, was based on the Morris Miner. So, following the Morris Miner is AV5909. It's in Orkney for over 10 years now. It's an 1140 side valve engine. Hydraulic brakes and 12 volt electrics, both of which were rather. There's a 1928 Lanchester Straight 8, owned by Walter Scott of Sindola. This is a.
But rather too many cars in the ring to go through the whole lot.
It's just these ones that go around, they're not in the cars.
And the next one, TOR516, is a 1936 Rockwell DY 12-6. That is Ben. Fixed on that one. It's a Pickford drop head for me. G. Midget. The M-type was the first production.
Russian midget. It was introduced in 1929. Bodied car. It is rarer than the fabric body models. It's owned by the present owners. It has been owned by the present owners, again by John Doe. And it was imported from South America in the early 1990s. And had been owned by, had been a one owner car there. It's a 24 horsepower side valve engine and that. Model A was the one that followed the Model D. We'll make a start for one that has got a fair amount of information there. That is MN6300, which is John Logue's Hotchkiss, 1930 Hotchkiss AM2, and it was hidden in a French haystack during the Second World War. The owner never came back for it, and it was 1996. That's the big blue Hotchkiss, John Logue's Hotchkiss.
Ha 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 ha. for you.
Yeah, it was a U, wasn't it?
U.
Yeah, well, you have a silver long here, then, you know, it's all.
Well, if you want to come out and see it.
You're getting the steam up, George.
Oh, that was the
Robbie Spence from Kirkwall. The tractor is out of plants and binder bits and this
Original tractor with original tires, bodywork and engine. So that one is totally original, just as it was bought. To be restored in the future. That's a restoration project.
I should wait a night, or two, or 10, or years, maybe.
Time to go. It's been a good day. Today, we're in St. Margaret's Hope. This is an Orkney Vintage Club road run day. We've come out to St. Margaret's Hope. Have a look.
It's Saturday the 4th of September. It's the start of Orkney Science Festival, and Orkney Vintage Club are having a display on Broad Street.
Definitely a superior class of caravan altogether. Don't you think? Don't know about the carpet tiles though.
That did.
It's altogether rather nice. Anyway, the event's more or less finished now, anyway.
outside the window.
What did I tell you? This is a different day now. This is Sunday the 12th of September. There's going to be a road run, as they call it, out to Birsay. Sorry about the squint camera handling, but I can't look through the viewfinder and speak into the microphone at the same time.
Inside. Uh-huh. I was going to tackle this wheel. I didn't cane this one this year, I would have seen it. I could still go and get it, I suppose.
So it's just after 20 past two. We are now leaving the East Church car park to head towards Finstown. this variation of actually going uphill. Intriguing. We must be going up the old Finstern Road. I suppose I can switch the camera off for a minute. Nah, let's just leave it running.
Michael Reid's Vauxhall Victor is right behind us. So it seems to be somewhere in the middle of the group. Wilsonley 1500 is leading the convoy. Behind it is the White Ford Consul convertible, which is Alvin Youngson's. Then there's a red up Clio. I'm not entirely sure what it's doing there, probably the same as me. Just following in for the fun of it. Then, of course, the Jensen Interceptor. Looking behind me, there's Michael Reid's Vauxhall Victor. I don't know what's behind that, I can't see. Far enough behind. Oh, I think it's the Triumph 2000. So that still leaves the Ford Classic and the Triumph Dolomite unaccounted for. And the Reliant Cab. See, the Ford Classic is out in front. It's actually leading us. It's a red Vauxhall Cavalier behind that. So no sign of the Triumph Dolomite or the Reliant Cab. it looks like they're like getting their way out in front, so they must all have left a while before I got underway. They're so far in front I couldn't see them. Quite a lot behind us actually. I don't know if they're following us specifically or are we just holding them up on their Sunday driving expedition. There's no sign of Triumph Dolomite among that lot, so it's probably in front of us, farther away than I can see yet. Here we are entering the cityscape of Finster. There's a car boot sale going on at Finster. I see a white box on Viva HC type. That should really join in with us. In registration. That'll be 1974 to 75 on an in. We're meeting some other members of the team here who have arrived here from elsewhere. I can see the Wolseley 444, I should say. It was the Queen's Royal Transport during Strummer's Shopping Week. There's a Vauxhall there, I don't remember. Oh, it's Bar 516. Austin and the MG. So it's going to be quite a convoy out to Birsay. After all.
Sorry about that, forgot I was zoomed in. There's the Triumph Dolomite and Ford Escort, which I forgot about. Very technically advanced. We are now setting off again for Doombee. I don't think there's any point in filming the rest of the journey out to Dundee, but I'll have a look around when I get there. It's just about 3 o'clock and we're in Dundee. My car doesn't really fit in, does it?
So now we leave Dunby for Birsay. Everybody else is gone, except me and the Rosalie 444.
Yeah.
lots of people here. Obviously, because we're all gathered here and because it's such a beautiful day, half of Orkney seems to be here. May not be a parking space. Everybody's turning here to go back the way they've come. Oh well, we're at the furthest end of Birsay now. There can be no driving further than this. As they say, so I might as well switch off the camcorder for the meantime.
What petrol do you burn?
Oh, that's about 15 to the gallon.
No. What do you put 4-star on?
Oh yeah, it has to have 4-star. It doesn't like anything.
No.
We're supposed to head down to the palace now. We're now at the Earl's Palace in Birsay.
Yeah, you are.
That festival and that.
Unlikely to become a future exhibit for Orkney Vintage Club. I can't really see that very well, but it says 1727. Or is it 1721? I think it's 1727.
Where the war memorial is in Ham, you haven't seen it. Where at the feet of that brae, there are room, there are park, there are room, humpy, how are you? That's a very old Catholic burial.
Oh, yes.
When we feather came home from the Navy, back in the First World War, him and the fellow and the other about it. They'd heard that this was an old burial ground. They thought they'd have a dig in it. And so that, well, he says, off, dig away. He says, you won't. He says, but he says, don't let a skull and crossbones on another. He says, come back. He says, where that sailor? He says, what's this great dig here?
Hey, well, that was greenhouses at one point. Robin Orkway had it, you know, on a kind of commercial basis, and he gave that up some years ago and lives in the upper flat, the old mines. Is that it does, yes.
When you looking around at this one, have you looked in a boat?
No.
I see Earl Robert Stewart had to pay for his water. back to the car. We are now at Boardhouse Mill. Tragic waste. These wheels could be in use for something. No point in having a wheel there if it's not doing anything. We're looking in through a small hole on the side of the smaller of these two buildings. I can't actually look for the camera now because I can't fit my head through the hole as well as the camera. Let's have a look elsewhere. Well, a difficult ground to walk on this. See, that wheel has slipped quite severely. It's scraping the wall at the top and it's clear at the bottom. It's a rather strange angle.
It's a shame those ends of those woods aren't that really good, are they?
We're about to see some movement here, I think. Or maybe not. It seems to be running at half pressure for some reason. Well, so it's going down the back. What took it so long to start moving? a very tight system.
I think.
Kiln or whatever they call it. It's a gauze floor, a mesh floor I should say. This must be one of the grates that feeds the kiln.